The sound of the suppressed ACR? Well, it's the sound of Modern Warfare 3. It is. And it may have been OP, but it was super nostalgic. You know what? Looking back, I truly, truly miss the Modern Warfare 3 days. We have done a lot of Call of Duty gun sound videos in the past, and every Call of Duty has some awesome gun sounds. Even the games with less memorable guns have some sounds that everybody could point out. Well, today we're gonna test your Call of Duty superfan status. We're gonna put you to the test a little bit. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the channel. Specifically, welcome to the video in the Every COD series. Today, well, we're gonna see if you can identify some guns by their sound. We are going to go through every single game from Call of Duty 4 all the way to Modern Warfare 2019 and pick out the single most iconic, most recognizable gun sound in every single game. So let me know which of these you think is the most iconic. Let me know how many you can actually guess up front without cheating. Circle of trust. Drop a like on this video, guys, if you're excited, and make sure you have your notifications turned on. Okay, there you have it. Let's see if you go one for one. COD 4, the M40A3. The gun that arguably invented quick scoping. The M40A3 was one of the bolt-action snipers in COD 4, and its quick handling and its silky smooth aiming made it a favorite. Not only for traditional sniping, but it also introduced COD to the aggressive sniper play, which would eventually become a staple of the entire series. The firing sound of the M40 was awesome. It echoed through the map every time you pulled the trigger, and quick scoping got big with Modern Warfare 2 and the Intervention. But it all started with COD 4 and the M40A3. Now, I think it is the most recognizable firing sound in that game. And if you knew Call of Duty World at War was next, you probably guessed this one. This is probably going to be the most easily identified sound. Now, you may have expected me to put the MP40 here, but if we're talking about most iconic gun sounds, I can't. Maybe most iconic guns I could. This is sounds, though, and I have to go with the meat grinder, the PPSH. The SMG. It was one of the fastest firing guns in COD history, and while its damage per bullet was low, its time to kill was absurd. When you pulled the trigger on this thing, it sounded like you were grinding up giant chunks of metal and meat, and you were shooting them right out of the barrel. It is definitely one of the coolest sounds in a video game. Now, I know the MP40 definitely got more playtime from the community, but the PPSH, by far, had the most iconic firing sound in World at War. No surprise here, all you OGs probably guessed this one. The Modern Warfare 2 Intervention. Now, MW2 had a ton of iconic sounding guns. This wasn't easy to do. You had the Barrett, you had the ACR, you had the suppressed UMP, but nothing was going to be able to top the Intervention. This bolt action sniper rifle was the one and only bolt action in the game. And it quickly became the go-to gun for aggressive sniper play and montages. The Intervention's handling made it great to use, and the firing sound, well, it made it oh so satisfying to fire. That sound alone has made it into probably millions of montages, edits, memes, you name it. I would even say it's the single most iconic gun sound in COD history, possibly. I doubt anybody's gonna disagree with me. Now we've arrived at Black Ops 1. You probably guessed this one too. And BO1 doesn't get enough credit for its sound design. It really doesn't. The sound effects all around in this game were really good. But of course, we're gonna be going with the FAMAS for the best gun. It was by far the most used gun in the game due to it being pretty obviously overpowered, even after a round of nerfs soon after launch day. It fired super quickly, it killed faster than the SMGs despite having the range of an assault rifle, and the firing sound, whew, it was unlike anything else we'd ever heard in Call of Duty at that time. It was so metallic and crunchy, almost as if the PPSH had grown up into a full adult. This is one of my favorite guns in COD history, and I think we can all agree here, right now, it's the most iconic sound from Black Ops 1. Now, I threw you for a little loop on this one. This is a lot harder than what you've seen so far. Modern Warfare 3, the suppressed ACR. It's a little specific, but come on, everybody knows, well, most people know it. The ACR 6.8 was by far the most popular assault rifle in this game, and according to many, it was overpowered. Personally, I don't think the gun was quite as OP as some people say it was, but there's no denying it was the best AR in the game. Just about everybody was running around with it, and a lot of people had the suppressed version and maybe some extended mags on top of that. And to me, the sound of the suppressed ACR, well, it's the sound of Modern Warfare 3. It is, and it may have been OP, but it was super nostalgic. You know what? Looking back, I truly, truly miss the Modern Warfare 3 days. And now we've reached Black Ops 2. Now, a lot of you were probably going to be expecting the Scorpion or the MSMC. I don't know, the AN-94. That's a super good one too, right? I went with the M8A1. I think it's one of the most recognizable guns from Black Ops 2. This was the 4-round burst assault rifle with a very high rate of fire and great damage output, making it one of the most popular guns in the game for both pubs and competitive. Now, the sound of those four shots coming out of the barrel, one burst right after another, it was fantastic. And the M8 may have not been the best gun in Black Ops 2. I think its fire sound and pattern make it by far the most recognizable if we're talking about sounds alone. I know the MSMC, the Scorpion, the AN-94, heck, even the, what was it, the Cheekum. Wasn't the Cheekum in this game too? Well, now that I look back and reflect, maybe the Cheekum was probably the most iconic, but I'm not going to put a fart cannon on this video. I'm giving it to the M8. Call of Duty Ghost. Did you guess the Honey Badger? Super unique gun, both in practice and design. It was an assault rifle that fired and handled very quickly, and it had an integrated suppressor for stealth. The sound design in Ghost was somewhat flat. It was somewhat unmemorable. A lot of guns sounded the same, but the Honey Badger, well, it stood above the rest. The pitter-patter of the bullets coming out sounded super unique, and it gave the gun a lot of character. Now, my second place choice for Ghost was the MTAR-X, which I know people loved, but I think if you asked 10 people right now what the best-sounding gun in Ghost was, I think at least 6 of them would say the Honey Badger. That's my guess, so we're gonna go with that one. Advanced Warfare, if you didn't guess this one well, you didn't play Battle of Duty. The BAL 27. The gun needs no introduction. It possibly one of the most hated guns in the franchise. I don't know, because of how overpowered it was. Despite getting a couple nerfs, the BAL was never fully brought back down to earth, and it remains one of the most spammed guns in COD history to this day. Now, with that being said, it did sound pretty cool. And the fact that the fire rate changed as you held the trigger down gave it even more memorable traits. So while it may have been hated by the community and overused by everybody, and why would you put this gun in a default class, everybody still remembers what it sounded like, and that is why it's on the list today. Now we've reached Black Ops 3 and the Locust. Now, BO3 had a ton of great weapons, ton of great sounds. I mean, I really feel it did. I don't think anybody was expecting this one in the sniping community. Black Ops 3 is probably the hardest sniping of any Call of Duty because of the lack of aim assist as well as the wall running and thrust jumping. With that being said, a massive sniping community came out of Black Ops 3 and that ended up making the Locust one of the most popular guns in multiplayer. It was supposed to be a quicker sniper for aggressive play, but it required you to aim high in order to get consistent one-shot kills. Now, the Locust is definitely a good sounding gun. And out of all the guns in BO3, I think it's probably the most recognizable. I definitely think it's cool how a game with such difficult sniping ended up having one of the most passionate sniping communities of any modern COD game. Infinite Warfare. The suppressed NV4. This gun is iconic for some of the wrong reasons, but it's here anyway. It was spammed ridiculously hard in Infinite Warfare because of how easy it was to use and how powerful it was on top of that. On paper, it wasn't special. But in practice, it was extremely strong, and a lot of people just chilled in corners and hallways with a suppressed NV4. Now, admittedly, this thing, it sounded really cool, and it fit in with the universe of the game, but it definitely pissed people off. The camping with suppressed NV4s was absurd in Infinite Warfare, but this is a video about iconic sounds, and it's definitely recognizable, so here it is. Call of Duty World War II, the STG-44. Now, it's appeared in a lot of COD games, but I think it may have been at its best in COD World War II. This is one of the most used guns in the game due to how easy it was to rack up kills, and the firing sound was a bonus. The STG in COD World War II actually reminded me a bit of the Black Ops 1 FAMAS because it fired fast and it sounded metallic, which was awesome. Now, due to it having such a distinct firing sound and also being one of the most used guns in the game, I think it's safe to say the STG-44 has the most iconic sound in COD World War II. And now that I think back, World at War, the STG was probably up there in that one as well. Two left. Black Ops 4, did you guess? The Matix. This was actually a hard pick because I don't feel like there are any really iconic gun sounds in Black Ops 4, but if we're gonna just go off the most recognizable firing sounds, I'm gonna go with the Matix. This was one of the most used guns in the game thanks to its high fire rate, great range, and easy handling. The Matix was a competitive rifle of choice and it was all over the place online. So while it may not have been, it didn't have the same impact as other guns on the list, I do think it has the most recognizable sound in Black Ops 4, and that is what this list is about. And finally, we've reached Modern Warfare 2019. I'm gonna surprise you here. The M4A1. Surprise, or pretend to be surprised. I know you're not. I don't think there's a gun in Modern Warfare that people are more acquainted with than this gun. It's the best gun on launch day. It's the best gun now. It's the best gun in multiplayer. It's the best gun in Warzone. Everybody knows that the Modern Warfare M4 sounds amazing, and everybody has blasted it in their ears for seemingly hours as entire lobbies just sit in corners and they fire them at each other. I know, if it sounds like I'm annoyed, it's because I am. I thought by this point the game's life cycle we'd be over this M4 craze, but Infinity Ward still hasn't fully nerfed the thing yet, so here we are. It just sucks, because I think Modern Warfare has so much potential as a game, but when stuff like this goes unchanged for so long, it seems like Infinity Ward is holding themselves back, and I don't see the logic. But once again, this isn't a video about that. This is about most iconic sounds, and I think the M4A1 probably has the most iconic sound. Then again, the HDR has quite a pop to it as well, but I'm going to give it to the M4A1. And there you have it. That is my picks for the most iconic gun sounds in COD history from every single Call of Duty. Let me know where you agree. Let me know where you disagree. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like, and I'll see you soon.